In the bottom left, our Zerg player. Very solid play style coming from this guy. He is
CoCa.
Zenix CoCa. And now to our other player in the upper right. We have our Terran, our sneaky Terran. Can he sneak his way into the next phase of Code S?
MVP Keen.
Imagine if Psy was Keens.
Keens?
Because then backwards would be Sneak.
Ooh. Ooh, like this. Finish him. Oh, is he going to drink the whole thing? Almost, almost. You know, it's hard to chug.
It is.
Cold liquid. It's not easy.
Yeah, cold liquid. It's like impossible.
Oh, God, that's terrible.
Yeah.
No, that's the worst yet. If you're going to chug something, it
makes
has
to. Makes my throat shiver.
Oh, it's bad. Then yeah. You know it's all that ice cold stuff just went down into your stomach.
Mm.
It's like you can't feel it anymore. It's like all weird.
Now, you have like a cold line going through the middle of your body.
Yeah.
Ends in warmth. What is that all about?
Ugh. You know, if you're going to chug something, it has to be room temperature.
Mm.
It's the only way to do it.
Agreed.
This is the chug tips here at the GSL.
Don't
help
chug
you guys
boiling water. Just because
do
we
it.
Told you ice water is bad, don't chug boiling water.
Yeah, don't do that. That would be
not
extra dumb. Barracks finishes. Zerg with the hatchery first and spawning pool shortly after. And we have a factory coming up here. He may very well just make a reactor here and just do reactored Hellions.
Yeah, definitely could be. I think Blue Flame Hellions, you know, they are all the rage. He is making the reactor for now. I think he will probably switch over to Blue Flame, though, after that. It's somewhat popular. One of the variations of the opening is to reactor out two Hellions, and while that's happening, you make a tech lab with the barracks.
Yeah, that's a good build.
Yeah, and then you just switch again and go Blue Flame, and then you kind of have like an extra Hellion. Every little thing tastes counts.
Absolutely. So whatever good Terran vs. Zerg build, or I guess I should say whatever the best Terran vs. Zerg build Keen has that he knows right now, we're about to see it, Artosis. He has one shot.
That's it, Tasis.
To make it through.
At the same time, you know what we're going to see from CoCa is probably the most defensive build that he can come up with.
Yeah, no kidding.
And, ooh, look at this. It's indeed going to be reactored Hellions and then a starport with a tech lab right next to it.
So it could be Banshees.
Yeah, we might see possibly Banshees. I would say most certainly we'll see at least one Banshee. I'm wondering about possible switch to Blue Flame, though, you know? Because if he's going to, like, do a one base all in, he may as well go Blue Flame with it. We'll see in a moment as the Banshee starts and he frees up a little bit more gas.
Nice Spinecrawler defense here from CoCa. That's actually, like, so perfectly placed.
Really well placed there. And, you know, he's got the Queens in the background. He's got a few Zerglings there as well.
Let's not forget that CoCa was actually here in the studio watching that game that Keen played against Alicia.
Yeah.
So he's probably looking at this going, oh.
Yeah, you're
Keen might be desperate.
People. Okay.
Oh, my God.
CoCa.
That sucks.
Well,
already
that
knows.
Is
okay.
Pretty huge. Pretty huge. And that Ling has seen far too much, Tasteless. He can't be kept alive. Meantime, these Hellions just trying to get some damage done. Hurting Queen, bruising up as much as possible. Realistically, CoCa right now. Well, he is making an Evolution Chamber, which is fine, but I would like to see more Queens. It was obviously not Cloaked Banshee being made.
Yeah.
And in that situation, I'd far prefer to have extra Queens. Far, far, far prefer.
Did CoCa actually see the it was only one gas build? He might have actually just thought that there was a second refinery.
Well, he saw that the tech lab wasn't upgrading at the minimum. I don't know if he actually saw that there was not a second gas.
You got more Hellions out now moving around the map. And as far as I could tell, it doesn't really look like Keen hold that thought. Actually, we got the engagement occurring here.
Notice he's connected the creep in between his main and natural.
Yep, very nice. Oh, my God.
Keen
lost
so
the Banshee.
Well, he's not dead.
You're not
but,
the best foe, you, but that was pretty bad Banshee control.
Yeah, that was a very important Banshee to get some damage done with. And look at that! another perfect Zergling running right in.
What
as
is happening?
He lowered the depot almost as if to let the Zergling in. Now the Zergling sees that there's a command center and it's not an all-in anymore. He can go back to making drones. Wow. Coca,
this game is making
good.
My brain hurt right now from what I'm seeing from Keen.
Dude, Coca, man. He's staying on top of everything, scouting well, etc. That's a good casting term.
Yeah, etc.
Like he's scouting well, etc. And everyone's like, what? I like that, actually. That's good.
That is pretty good. Now the expansion.
Banelings, so many banelings, etc.
So many banelings, etc., etc.
Things dying, etc.
Fast expansion, etc.
Banshee build, etc. And you're like, what? No, I actually don't know what you mean. There's all sorts of things that come out of Banshee.
All right, here comes the drop now. Note he is going for the medevac.
It's a nice move to start, but these Hellions getting in here. Oh, not good hits so far. Kills a good number of Zerglings, but...
This attack was a failure.
Yeah, that was a failure.
Rarely do you see a game where every single thing that could possibly go wrong actually goes wrong. And that's what we're seeing here from Keen.
Yeah, well, he's taking the gold base in the top left to try to start a comeback of some sort.
Yeah, I don't blame him for doing that either.
And he's guarding that top watchtower as well with a couple, three Hellions and a Banshee, so that's something that's going to be harder to scout. So, I mean, he's taking the necessary steps to try to come back into this. He's still in the game. Spire is only half done. Burrow and Baneling speed on the way. Five creep tumors are out. Eight creep tumors are out. That's a lot of creep tumors.
That is.
Yeah. Being very smart with those extra queens. Really get his creep on.
Uh-oh. All right. He is... Oh, I thought he was going to go up there to the upper left with those Zerglings.
Keen would not have been happy with that. He's making an orbital up there.
Well, you know, in a situation like this, I feel like people should always just have something at the gold bases.
Yeah, they should always
because,
be checking.
Because, let's face it, like... The gold bases are in an obscure location. It's not something that's kind of a risk to take, but it's out in the middle of the map, so everybody knows. Somebody like Keen is going to take that gold base.
Yeah, very true. Many people do.
Yeah. Now, right now, I think Coca's angle for this game is to just play safe and play standard.
Yes, definitely. You know, he's making that macro hatch, taking his third base with good timing.
And we see a lot of gold... gold base mules here, so Keen's going to get an edge in here now, or I think I guess the next few minutes is going to be the moment when that occurs.
If he were to just run up there, man, the game would go so heavily into his favor, but as is, Keen is definitely catching up. Just having golds at that base, mine so many minerals, a ridiculous amount.
All right, right now, Coca perhaps being a little bit too passive. Considering he hasn't actually checked that location in the upper left.
It's quite true.
And
I
the
think
way
he's focusing right now, not like losing any drones.
Yeah.
That's the only thing on his mind is, okay, don't lose drones. Just play safe. Don't die right now. You'll be fine.
Now, there is an Overlord that's heading up towards this expansion location. So in about a minute here, he should know.
Yeah, he should be sending one out. But at this time... Turrets are going up at that
base. Like hid in the trees. It's like Han or something. He just like runs into a back path.
Huh.
Now we have more and more siege tanks being cranked out here. Keen is now even in supply. Okay, wait. I think check out the upper set part of the map, Artos. I think now he knows. Yeah, he knows.
Yeah, he knows now, Tasteless. He doesn't know how long it's been there, but the Overlord has spotted it. And if Zerglings run up there, which they are doing... There's
they just
nothing
need to get
over
those
there
turrets.
Yet. Yeah, they might do a great job here. Taking out some SCVs first.
And nice job here. You know, this is why he probably should have made that into a planetary. When you have a gold base that's really far out in an obscure location, you need to have a planetary there with the turrets. That way the Zerg, once you take it, they just don't get to reclaim it ever.
We have something pretty cool happening. Keen is actually going to move that.
Oh my
that
god!
Over to his natural third.
Yeah, Jeff, we can get a shot of this.
Look at that!
Look at that! Oh my god! We're about to see one of the sexiest plays.
Well, he's making turrets there right away.
But if that lands and he just transfers SCVs, oh my god, that would be so sick.
Yeah, that would be pretty insane.
Oh my god, this is going to be so cool.
Now Keen has a lot of spies going in the middle of the map. He's sieging up, and Coca almost pulled the trigger there. Almost pulled the trigger.
That was close.
One of Keen's missile turrets overlapped with a Baneling and wouldn't build Tasteless. I wonder if he knows.
I don't think he does, though. But we'll see.
SCVs are coming over.
Oh,
SCVs are coming over. Will he notice?
Okay, get ready. Really? You're not going to detonate him?
Oh, really?
Really?
Sorry, CoCa. Good try.
All right, CoCa.
You had the chance. You blew it. Well, right now, very similar supplies, 156 to 153. CoCa just slightly in the lead. It is 57 drones to 53 SCVs, so CoCa is actually, he's not in such good shape.
No, he's not.
And
right,
here
he's
he goes.
Attacking.
The tanks weren't siege, but the Banelings, they can't be wasted on siege tanks.
Still there's still one or two left. Banelings under there. Huh.
Well, he's eliminated a decent number of siege tanks, but Keen is on two facts, continuing to pump him out. He's got a lot of medevacs still. His upgrade's only at 1-0, as are Keen's. I mean, as are CoCa's.
Well, now CoCa's taking the bottom right location on the map. Keen is still very keen on pushing, no pun intended.
Yeah, you intended that.
I intended that. I'm that guy.
Well, you know, it looks like Keen's push, I would say without any doubt, is going to take out some bases here. In fact, it might catch a ton of drones!
Oh, no!
Oh, this is not good at all. Actually, surprising.
And, of course, he gave away that he has that expansion. But look at this. CoCa with a counterattack over here. He's going to intercept these SCVs if they try to retreat.
Quite right, Tasteless. And, well, it looks like he will end that base again. But going down to two base versus two base is not what is going to be beneficial for CoCa, really.
Right, he's targeting down the orbital, and it will go away. How many minerals are in the natural of Keen's?
Oh,
that's
got,
actually a lot.
Yeah, he's got almost 1,000 per patch.
I don't know, Artosis. Look at the little gold mineral sticking out of the ground.
Marine grabs it, tries to pull it up. No, Marine, you're on an SCV. Stop that.
You know, I don't think Keen could be stopped right now.
Yeah, he might not be.
His guy, he just has this ball that is too big of Marines and siege tanks, and yeah.
Well, there's still a few things working for CoCa. He has 24 Mutalisks. Of course, there's 70 Marines out, but with 24 Mutas, you can put on a good amount of pressure.
Right.
You know, you can hit the main base. You can missile turrets no longer matter. You just kind of right-click them, and they disappear. He's still got a decent amount of drones at 60 against the 49 SCVs. He's got two mining bases with the third one that's started again already. But it looks like, I mean, Keen, I think, is just going to do one solid attack here, and he's already so close to CoCa's base that, uh-oh, CoCa, well, he's trying to snipe some
CoCa
tanks.
Doesn't seem to have the position here to do a counterattack, and I don't know exactly, I mean, I would not want to face off against Keen's army right now.
No.
It is actually just too scary.
Yeah, no, you don't want to fight it head on.
Oh my god, Baneling attack over here at the expansion.
It's a nice move, but they're both stuck at the same supply right now. 15 more army supply for Keen. This is frightening, man.
Basically,
he has to get some lucky Banelings. I think that's what it comes down to.
I don't even think Keen actually has to try to kill him. Keen actually could just wait for the circuit to try to expand again and just kill that expansion. He doesn't have to go into the main.
That's quite true, but it looks like CoCa is going to take it to Keen and do a counterattack.
All right, here we go.
Well, here he goes. There's no turning back now, Tasteless. Both players in the base trade scenario.
He got a base trade.
Possibly he can make these orbitals. Actually, if he can... The orbitals, he has no scan left. So burrowed Banelings could be huge right now. But he hasn't burrowed any. There's no scans,
right,
but he hasn't burrowed any.
A little bit up at the top of the screen here. He's going to get this one orbital. And then there's one more orbital down there at the bottom. However, I don't...
You know, if he had burrowed at the top of the ramp, he could have killed every Marine.
It's like every Marine is perfectly angled around that.
CoCa right now just making a ton of Banelings, using all of his money on that. It all comes down to this, but the siege tanks are going to siege up.
Right,
Banelings are now under the siege tanks. That's not going to help. It's going to be 45 damage to the siege tanks.
Muta's attacking.
Yeah,
okay, that was
really
not
help.
Exciting.
Well, Tasteless, this is the difference between Nest T and every other Zerg.
Yeah.
ST would have had Banelings on top of his ramp, burrowed, and he would have killed that army.
It looks like Keen has managed to sneak his way into the next phase of Code S. Congrats to him.
Yep. In the meantime, well, it's still a base trade. Does he have any mutas left? I'm looking for buildings. There's almost no buildings left.
Well, I think right now it's like two extractors or something and a spire.
Yeah, there's... You're quite right. He only has 15 minerals. He has one muta, 61 lings.
And this orbital can just float over to the bottom right side of the map.
Cannot
so one
be
muta
hit.
Has to try to hit it. And this, when the structure goes, I think that's the last one. Artosis, GG.
CoCa was defeated.
Crazy day with base trades going on. Well done, Keen.
Yeah.
You know, I don't know if he had all this stuff on paper to make it through this, but he picked his strategies wisely. And he has now gotten that much farther in Code S. And CoCa, a crushing defeat. That was a tough decision to make that counterattack.
It would have worked if he had just set up some Banelings at the top of his ramp. CoCa is very upset. He realizes that actually he is a player that probably should be in the round of 16.
Yeah. But that's the name of the game. You know, in StarCraft, you can play standard. You could take some risks like Keen's done. You can do all-ins. And right now, today is Keen's day.
It's
Did not expect whose
day is tomorrow, though?
What?
It's your day. It's your birthday tomorrow.
Yeah, it's my birthday tomorrow.
Everyone,
actually,
go on Twitter and
you guys don't
hit
need to do
at
that.
Call me Tasteless and tell him happy birthday because he deserves it. He only gets two birthdays a year. He's a selfish guy. Most of us only get
three birthdays a year. I have a quarterly birthdays.
three.
I have trimesters of birthdays.
Yeah.
I actually forgot.
You're like a hockey game.
I forgot. Like somebody.
I know.
Called
I was talking. I called you. That was me.
Yeah, that was you. Okay. I was. Well,
you like just woke up.
Well, you like woke me up.
Oh, by the way, it's my birthday tomorrow. I'm like, I know. He's like, yeah, I forgot. I'm like, oh
yeah,
my God,
I forgot it's my birthday. So I don't even know what I'm gonna do.
Yeah.
So
well, you're gonna have a birthday party, man. I'm gonna be there.
Excellent.
Like, actually, you're not. I'm like, oh.
Sorry, Artosis, it's a private party. I gotta break it to you, man. No, of course, we're going to have a cool party. So we have Keen and Nana. I got to say, I'm really surprised that Keen made
well,
it out.
It's the player I most expected to make it out and the player I least expect to make it out.
Yeah.
So I guess it was a balance of the middle of my expectations. It's a perfect balance.
Well said, Artosis.
I'm sad about Alicia and CoCa. I feel like I would actually...
Well, today's kind of a sad day for them. I mean, you could see the way Alicia lost was kind of, you know, was kind of heartbreaking. And then, you know, CoCa.
Well, they both made mistakes, man. They both made mistakes.
So, as you can see, for Group C, which we haven't done yet, we're going to be doing that, I think, next week.
Yeah, next...
Because Puck is out of town.
Next Tuesday morning in Korean time, we're going to be doing that for you guys. Morning for a nerd is, of course, afternoon.
Yeah, man. I stayed up so late last night playing Demon's Souls. I woke up at like 3:30 p.m.
Wow.
Yeah.
No, I know.
I've only been awake for a few hours.
You.
Yeah.
Oh, like, why are you calling me? You're so rude, Artos. I'm like, actually, we have to go to work soon.
I did not say that, Artos. I was like, call me back. Call me back. Now, sorry again, guys. It's going to be a little bit of a shorter day, but that's just the way things are turning out. There's more than enough StarCraft in the world to keep anybody who wants to watch more StarCraft entertained.
Yep.
Please do participate in our contest. Get some photos with you and Pepsi.
Definitely.
And, you know, send us pictures. Do something funny, something creative, guys.
Well, here's a round of 16 for Code A. One of the days at least. Fruit Dealer against Gonzi. Ooh, that'll be good. SC against Teja. Ooh, that's a nice match. Dongregu against JYP. I'll be watching that one. Tassar against Yoda. Wow, that's actually a great day of matches.
Yeah, that's going to be a lot of fun.
Wow, that is like a lot of Code S guys actually in there, man. Actually,
well,
every player there should be in Code S.
Artosis, they're actually all Code A.
I know, but they could be Code S. Some of them have been.
Some of them have been, that's true.
Some of them maybe will be.
I'm going to be 27 tomorrow.
That's pretty old, man. You're getting up there.
27, it's not a bad age to hit. You know what I mean? It's like...
I remember when I hit 27.
That was like
was
10
right.
years ago. Nah, he's only 28. Wait, how old are you?
28.
You're 28? All right.
I'm like, I'm 32. You're like, what?
I'm 27. 27 is not a bad age to turn, though. It's like,
well, you don't know. Look at this guy talking. He doesn't even know. You haven't turned 27.
What
shut
do I know. But, you know, the feeling you get, like, you know, when you turn 22, it's kind of like, eh.
Yeah.
It's not exciting when you're 21, but 27 is like good. It's like a good age. 26 was fine too.
Yeah.
25, I was like, well, I'm 25. It's a little weird.
Yeah, middle of your 20s. Now you're going to be in your late 20s as of tomorrow.
Yeah.
You're no longer in the middle of your 20s. You're not mid-20s, you're late 20s.
I'm in my late 20s crisis.
Yeah.
How did I spend my 20s? Did I do it right? Like,
I think you did.
I did, of course. Of course I did.
It's been based around StarCraft days.
So yeah, man.
My teens and my 20s.
Yeah.
StarCraft, man.
StarCraft life. Thank you to our sponsors at Pepsi. Pepsi, guys, please do participate in this contest. It's a lot of fun. Don't just be like there with the Pepsi, like,
No, you gotta do something funny. You gotta make him this sword and hit your friend on the head with it.
Yeah.
He's blocking with his Pepsi shield, like from Captain America, the worst movie I've ever seen.
Is it bad?
It's terrible.
I looked at it and I'm like,
I'm actually angry I didn't
that,
walk
if
out.
If I watch that movie, it might be 2 hours of my life I never get back.
The biggest mistake of my life was not seeing Captain America. It was not walking out of Captain America.
Whoa, damn. That is pretty harsh words here from Artosis.
That was a terrible film. Oh, my God.
Well, what time? It's like 8:12. We're getting out pretty early.
Yeah, it's a pretty quick day.
I'm going to go on a mandate.
All right.
All right.
Where are you going to bring me? Somewhere nice?
Probably the arcade.
All right.
Street Fighter. Yeah, I mean, that does it. Feels kind of weird finishing work this quick, but
yeah.
Luckily, we had some good games. We had that great Nada Alicia game. Recommend those games. It's really rare with two players at that skill set
to
get in a situation like that.
It was like a floating building.
Yeah.
Against
it's like
a pylon.
Thank God I made my starport on this side of my base, because if this building is destroyed, I lose the game because all my other buildings are gone. I mean, it's crazy. Add us on Twitter. You can see the Golem's Twitter at the bottom of our screen. Check out our mobile services. And, you know, I'm Call Me Tases on Twitter, at Artosis. Feel free to tweet at us. We read
me on Google Plus, too. I'm using that a lot now.
Yeah, I just got
an
account. I
don't know how to link you. I'm sorry.
Yeah, I don't know. I just got a Google Plus account.
Yeah, I sent you that invite, man. You gotta set it up.
Well, I have it set up.
Okay.
I have one. I have to upload stuff.
It's a great social networking thing.
It's better than Facebook. Facebook is so bad.
It's so bad.
Facebook is like so bad.
I still use
like,
it. But
really,
it's like,
you know, yeah.
Google
well, I mean,
Plus
like,
eats it, man.
It's like how I could talk to like my, you know, my aunt or something because she's not like hip enough to be on Google Plus. But Facebook is so bad. So yeah, I'm only gonna be using Twitter and Google Plus soon.
There you go. Perfect.
Yeah, heard it here. Heard it here. And MySpace. No, I'm kidding. Remember MySpace? Remember that?
Yeah, I remember that.
We can, like, make internet timelines. Like, that was a specific... Okay, well, we're out of time. Thank you guys so much for joining us. I'll see you guys next time here at the GSL. Take care.